Pay attention and be quiet. That's right. Task number one, listen to the audio and complete the sentence with the words you hear. We have three dialogues, and in each dialogue have two sentences. So we must fill in the blanks with the words that you hear in the dialogues. Vamos a escuchar entonces los audios para llenar estos espacios en blanco. En cada uno de estos tenemos dos oraciones que pues tenemos que llenar. For example, dialogue number one, sentence one. John wants to change his to business. Sentence number two, Sarah advised John to study. Now, in the dialogue number two, we have the sentence number three. Gordon needs to go to the store and buy flowers for his. Number four, Mark $50 to Gordon several days ago. And finally, the dialogue number three. Sentence number five. Claire plays the, dice, Claire toca, me imagino que es algún instrumento musical, ¿no? Number six, it is sometimes difficult to find work as an, es difícil encontrar trabajo como. Y pues aquí tenemos que escuchar entonces en primer lugar los audios, chicos, pongan atención. Dialogue number one.
Dialogue one. Sarah, you know me well. Should I change my major from math to business? I can't decide.
Tell me, John, are you a risk taker?
Not really. I'm usually pretty careful.
Businessmen have to take risks sometimes. Are you a confident person?
Of course not. I'm never sure of anything.
Math would be perfect for you, my friend.
Now, dialogue number two.
Dialogue two. Hey, Gordon, where are you going?
I'm going to the store, Mark. I need to buy flowers for my girlfriend.
That's cool. You're a generous person.
Everybody should give a girl flowers sometimes.
I never do.
That's because you're cheap.
Maybe, but I lent you $50 last week, remember?
Dude, I'm joking. Don't be serious.
And finally, dialogue three.
Dialogue three.
Hey, Bill, I need to go to my violin practice.
You're always so busy, Claire.
I know. I feel so tired. It's hard for musicians to find a job. I should just give up.
Don't be so negative. You're talented and very hardworking. You're going to be a famous musician. I just know it.
Thanks, Bill. Look, I really have to run.
Okay, students, I know. You need to listen again. Sí, van a tener que escuchar de nuevo. Lo sé, no estaba muy fácil.
John wants to change his major.
Excellent. John wants to change his major to business. No, quiere cambiar, dice pues su carrera, ¿no? Number two. Heidi.
Sarah advises John to study math.
Excellent. Sarah advises John to study math. Now, Camila, please, number three.
Gordon needs to go to the store and buy flowers for his girlfriend.
For his girlfriend. That's right. Dorian, number four, please.
Math.
A ver, no le escuché muy bien. ¿Puedes repetir? Mark. Lent. Como habíamos visto, prestarse dice lent, pero aquí está en pasado, ¿no? Con la T al final, no es lent, sino lent. $50 to Gordon several days ago. Diaz Steven, please, number five.
Claire plays the violin.
Excellent. Claire plays the violin. And finally, Mejia Pablo, number six.
It is sometimes difficult to find work as a musician.
As a musician, that's right. It's difícil encontrar trabajo como músico, ¿no? Okay, task number two. Listen again, write the name next to the matching personality description. We have the four names about these dialogues, John, Mark, Gordon, and Claire. And we have six sentences. So in these blanks, we must write the name. En estos espacios en blanco, nosotros vamos a escribir el nombre, chicos. ¿Sí? Dependiendo de cada uno de ellos. For example, is not confident. Who is not confident? ¿Quién no es o no tiene confianza en sí mismo, no? Vamos a escuchar los diálogos. Ah, bueno, aquí también tenemos la número dos, ¿no? Only thinks about bad things. Solo piensa en cosas malas. Number three. Is afraid of making bad decisions. Tiene miedo de tomar malas decisiones. Number four, doesn't like to spend money. No le gusta gastar dinero. Number five, works all the time. Trabaja todo el tiempo. And finally, number six, likes to buy things for people. Le gusta comprar cosas para la gente, ¿no? Entonces aquí lo que vamos a hacer es poner el nombre de cada uno de ellos, John, Mark, Gordon o Claire, según corresponda. Escuchemos el audio.
Dialogue 1. Sarah, you know me well. Should I change my major from math to business? I can't decide.
Tell me, John, are you a risk taker?
Not really. I'm usually pretty careful.
Businessmen have to take risks sometimes. Are you a confident person?
Of course not. I'm never sure of anything.
Math would be perfect for you, my friend.
Dialogue 2. Hey, Gordon, where are you going?
I'm going to the store, Mark. I need to buy flowers for my girlfriend.
That's cool. You're a generous person.
Everybody should give a girl flowers sometimes.
I never do.
That's because you're cheap.
Maybe, but I lent you $50 last week, remember?
Dude, I'm joking. Don't be serious. Dialogue 3.
Hey, Bill, I need to go to my violin practice.
You're always so busy, Claire.
I know. I feel so tired. It's hard for musicians to find a job. I should just give up.
Don't be so negative. You're talented and very hardworking. You're going to be a famous musician. I just know it.
Thanks, Bill. Look, I really have to run.
Muy bien, chicos. Entonces, de la misma manera, vamos a ir participando. Levanten la mano. Okay, who is not confident? Camila.
John.
John. A ver, review the answer. That's right, John is not confident. Now, Abigail, who only thinks about bad things?
Claire,
excellent. Pablo Mejia, who is afraid of making bad decisions?
John.
John, that's right, excellent. Diaz Steven, number four, who doesn't like to spend money?
Mark.
¿A quién no le gusta gastar? Mark, muy bien. Por eso le decía que es tacaño, ¿no? Number five, Karen, who works all the time?
Claire.
Claire, excellent. And finally, Who likes to buy things for people? Any volunteer? Maybe Darlene. Number six.
Gordon,
that's right. Excellent. Thank you, Darlene. Okay, go to the act it out exercise. Use the word choice giving. Practice the conversation with your partner. So we have some expressions in this part. Please, Shuleidi, can you read the words? Shuleidi, are you there? Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, por favor, las palabras.
Generous, confident, fun-loving, risk-taking, likes to share, believes in herself, loves to go to Paris, tires nothing often, cheap, native, serious, careful, doesn't like to spend money, is never happy, doesn't smile often, seldom takes risks.
Thank you. Muy bien, entonces vamos a la primera, ¿no? El primer diálogo corto. Speaker A, is, aquí usted debe poner un nombre, ¿no? Name. Yo puedo aquí, por ejemplo, is Sheila a generous. Puede elegir alguna de estas opciones que tiene aquí arriba en la primera línea. Is Sheila a generous person? And the speaker B says, yes, she likes to share, for example, ¿no? Sí, a ella le gusta compartir. ¿Está entendido el ejercicio, chicos? Do you understand? Any question?
Yeah. Dicen, ¿podría repetir qué hacer? Es que le escuché entrecortado.
Ya, listo, a ver, eso así. Cuando me pregunta, pues yo ya sé que no he escuchado. ¿O no ha entendido? Listo. Tenemos que llenar estos espacios en blanco para completar estos diálogos cortos. De la siguiente manera. Por ejemplo, aquí arriba usted tiene adjetivos para describir a una persona, ¿no? Generous, confident, fun loving, risk taking. En esta segunda línea usted tiene las características de cada una de estas personas. Por ejemplo, generous, likes to share. Generoso, le gusta compartir. Confident, confiado, o sea que tiene confianza en sí mismo. Aquí tiene la característica, ¿no? Believes in himself or herself, cree en sí mismo o sí misma. Fun loving, amante de la diversión. Loves to go to the parties, ama ir a las fiestas. And finally, risk taking, tomando riesgos o arriesgado sería aquí en español, ¿no? Risk taking. Tries new things often. Prueba nuevas cosas a menudo. Como pueden ver, cada una corresponde, cada adjetivo tiene una característica. Entonces, aquí en el diálogo número uno, lo que debe hacer es combinar, ¿no? Por ejemplo, puedo poner yo, is Christian a confident person? ¿Es Christian una persona confiada? ¿O tiene confianza en sí mismo? Yes. He believes in himself. Sí, él cree en sí mismo. Do you understand? Any question? No. Continue, please. And the dialogue 2 and dialogue 3. In the first place, any volunteer? Any volunteer? Steven, can you read me your first dialogue?
Okay. Is Paul a confident person? Yes, he believes in
his ability. Yes, he believes in himself. Excellent. That's right. Christian, please, can you read me your first dialogue?
He's Christian, a serious person.
Muy bien, ¿y cómo?
Yes.
Continue, please.
Yes, he don't smile of.
Ok, parece que tiene problemas con el audio, Christian. Abigail, can you read me your dialogue number one, please?
Is Lupe a confident person? Yes, she believes in herself.
Excellent, that's right. And finally, Camila, please read me your example, number one.
Is Daniela a fun-loving person? Yes, she loves to go to parties.
Excellent, she loves to go to the parties. Entonces, la relación sería la siguiente, ¿no? Para la primera parte, pues llenamos con alguna de estos adjetivos que acabamos de revisar. Y para llenar, pues, la segunda parte, las características de cada uno de estos adjetivos. No estaba complicado este diálogo. Ahora sí, vamos al número 2. Ahí quiero escuchar las opciones, ¿ya? Heidi, please, can you read me your dialogue?
You are too negative sometimes. Maybe you're right. I'm not passive enough.
Excellent. Muy bien. Sí. Como pueden ver, entonces, aquí la relación era con estos adjetivos. Chip, negative, serious, and careful. Y pues, con el antónimo sería, ¿no? Usted tiene ahí en el libro. Puede ver que entre paréntesis está el antónimo, ¿no? Now. A ver, ¿quién no ha participado aún? Karen, please. Can you read me your example? Number two.
Profe, yo tengo el, yo hice igual con negative.
A ver. Bueno, entonces, reconfiguren sus respuestas, chicos, para hacerles leer en esta parte. Yo sí les dije, esta segunda parte, tal vez se vayan a confundir. ¿Ya? A ver, y levanta la mano los que ya vayan terminando. Para hacerles participar y que lean, pues, el diálogo. ¿Ya? A ver, Dorian, ¿cómo te quedó tu ejemplo?
El primero.
El segundo, el diálogo número 2. You are too.
You are too serious sometimes. Maybe you are right. I'm not happy enough.
Muy bien. You are too serious sometimes. Maybe you're right. I'm not fun loving enough. Excellent. Karen, please.
You are too careful sometimes. Maybe you're right. I'm not risk taking enough.
Excellent. That's right. You are too careful sometimes. Maybe you're right. I'm not risk taking enough. Now, Darling Minaya, please. Dialogue number two.
You are the negative sometimes. Maybe you're right and confident.
Excellent. Maybe you're right. I'm not confident enough. No soy lo suficientemente confiado. And finally, dialogue number three. It was easy. Ese estaba un poco más fácil. Veamos entonces, Ariana, please, can you read me your dialogue number three?
Ellie is quite careful. Yes,
She is.
Yes, she.
Yes, she is.
A ver, aquí lo que deberíamos haber elegido es alguna de estas características de los adjetivos chip, negative, serious, or careful, ¿no? Como pueden ver, hay una relación. Y pues finalmente, aquí lo que debería haber contestado, yeah, she seldom takes risks. No toma riesgos a menudo, ¿no es cierto? Eso es lo que debía haber puesto aquí en la respuesta. A ver, Díaz, Steven, can you read me your dialogue number 3?
Okay, teacher. A ver. Paul is quite serious. Yeah. He's don't smile up.
Excellent. He doesn't smile often. Él no sonríe a menudo. Pablo Mejía, read me your dialogue, number 3.
Paul is quite cheap. Yeah, he doesn't like to spend money.
Excellent, that's right. Sí, no estaba complicado esto. Una participación más y pues para continuar. Listo, Camila, please, can you read me your dialogue?
Sophia is cute, negative. Yeah, she is never happy.
She is never happy. Excellent. That's right. So finally, we are in the Did You Know? Learn word families to expand your vocabulary. Fill in the blanks with the words given. Dice aprenda familias de palabras para expandir su vocabulario. Llene los espacios en blanco con las opciones dadas. Karen, please read the options.
Fun-loving, risk-taker, talented, hard-working, make friends, and risk-taking.
Muy bien, estos son entonces familias de palabras, ¿no? Vamos a ver cómo podemos nosotros aquí ir distribuyéndolas. For example, number one, he is a risk-taker or risk-taking. A ver, aquí tenemos estas dos opciones, ¿no? A ver aquí, Christian. What is the correct option? Risk taker or risk taking? Christian.
Risk taker.
Risk taker, excellent. He's a risk taker. Él es un arriesgado. He takes risk. Él toma riesgos. He is a risk taker or risk taking person. Abigail.
Risk taking.
Excellent. And that's right. Yes. So please finish the exercise. Vamos a ir llenando el ejercicio, chicos. If you finish, please hand your app. A lo que termine, levanta la mano para que participe.
She has a talent.
She's talented. Excellent. Thank you. Number 3, please, Heidi.
I work hard. I am a hardworking person.
Hardworking, that's right. Shuleidi, please, number 4.
Hi, ¿me escucha?
Yes.
We love fun. We grow up loving people.
Fun loving people, excellent. And finally, Merino Miguel, number 5.
They are friendly. They make friends easily.
They make friends easily. That's right. Muy bien, chicos, como pueden ver, entonces hemos visto ya más vocabulario. Vamos a continuar en la siguiente página. We are in the page 74, conversation. The topic is tell me what to do. Dime qué hacer. Bueno, aquí nosotros en las diapositivas lo que tenemos es el video acerca de esta conversación. Sí, entre el consejero y Rachel, advisor and Rachel. Pero usted en el libro debe realizar un ejercicio, ¿no? Llenar los espacios en blanco. ¿Sí? The instruction is listen and fill in the blanks with the words she's given. What are the words? Abigail, please read the words.
Long, hardworking, confident, rough, experienced, trouble.
Thank you. Esas son las palabras, pues, que vamos a utilizar para llenar esos espacios en blanco. ¿Alguna pregunta acerca de estas palabras? ¿O conocen la definición de cada uno de ellos? Drop, abandonar, bajar, caer. ¿Sí? A ver, las demás están fácil. Goal, objetivo, hardworking, trabajar duro, confident, confiado, drop, ya acabamos de ver, experience, experiencia, and trouble, significa problemas, ¿no? Bueno, tiene dos significados este trouble. Ahí tienen un par de minutos, chicos, para que vayan leyendo la conversación y luego pues ya escuchamos y vemos el video para que simplemente usted corrobore las respuestas, ¿sí? Ahí tiene unos 2 o 3 minutos para que usted termine de leer esta conversación. Be quiet and pay attention.
A student comes into an advisor's office.
Hi, Rachel. How can I help you?
Hello. I'm having trouble with my schoolwork. The midterms are coming up.
You're a hardworking student. You'll do great.
I am taking too many classes this semester. I also have a part-time job in a bank. I aim to get some real-world experience, but I'm under a lot of stress. I'm having difficulty finding enough time to do everything.
Can you leave your job?
I need the money.
If you take out student loans, you don't need to work.
My goal is to find a good job in finance. If I keep my job, I might make it happen.
You should just drop one class.
But which class? The deadline is around the corner. I might fail all my classes.
Don't be so negative. You should feel more confident about yourself. Why don't you take 2 weeks off? If your boss likes you, he will let you.
That's a good idea. Thanks for the advice.
That's right. Do you need to listen again? No. Estaba fácil, ¿no? No, no creo que necesitemos escuchar de nuevo. O tal vez alguien. No, muy bien. Okay, students, we're going to read all the line, ¿ya? Vamos a leer toda la línea cuando le nombre. Camila, please, number one.
Hello, I am having trouble with my schoolwork. The midterms are coming up.
Excellent. I'm having trouble with my schoolwork. Number two, Hugo.
Your experience to the Greek.
No, that's not correct. Karen, number two, please.
You're a hardworking student. You're doing great.
You are a hardworking student. That's right. That's the correct answer. Number three, please, Abigail.
I'm talking to many classes this semester. I also have a part-time job at the bank. I am to get some real world experience, but I'm under a lot of stress. I'm having difficulty finding enough time to do everything.
Excellent. Real world experience. That's right. Number four. Mejia Pablo.
My goal is to find a good job in finance. If I get my job, I may take it happen.
My goal, that's right. Ian, number five, please.
You should just drop one class.
Okay? Muy bien, drop. That's the correct answer. And finally, number six, Karen.
Don't be so negative. You should feel more confident about yourself. Why don't you take 2 weeks off? If your boss likes you, he will let you.
Excellent. You should feel more confident about yourself. That's right. Eso entonces tenemos, chicos. Y pues aquí nos vamos a quedar. Se nos ha acabado el tiempo.